Digging through my junk pile, I have found an old fiberglass spreader, or what's left of one. There used to be like four of these. It was half aluminum tubing and half fiberglass. And this, I think it was a spreader for a Moonraker 4 for the quad reflector. But I think I'm going to use this piece of fiberglass and see if I can find a piece of tubing that this will fit into. And then I will use this as the top of the mast. Okay, this is how I'm going to put the hardware together here in the end of the fiberglass spreader. What I'm going to do is take a. My hole is actually a little bit large, but I'm working with the number 6 hardware, and I'm going to stick with that. This is a 6 by 32 by 3/4 inch machine screw, and that might actually be just a little bit long. I may have to cut that off or find a shorter one. But because my hole's a little bit large, and I actually want to add a little more friction inside of there, this is an internal tooth lock washer. I'm going to slide that on there first, and then I'm going to take a regular number 6 flat washer and put that on there. And then I'm going to put that up here in this hole like that. And then I'll take the two large fender washers and put those on there. And then I'll take a regular split lock washer and then a number 6 nut and put that on there. And I'll just go ahead and leave this loose, and then this way I can slip the wire between the two large washers there and then tighten it down, and that'll be ready to go. My next step is to take my copper wire and get that cut. Go back to the diagram here. My length is, side length is 23 feet 8 inches, or 7.214 meters. 23 feet 8, I'm going to go ahead and add at least 4 inches, make that 24 feet on this side and this side. And that gives me 4 extra inches for tuning. This part up here will be a fixed point. So this will be 4 inches longer on this side, 4 inches longer on this side. So it looks like I need to cut a piece of wire that is 48 feet long. So here I have 48 feet of wire cut. The sides of the antenna are 23 feet 8 inches. And I just rounded that up to 24 feet. To give me 4 extra inches on each side. And what I did was I measured 24 feet, and then I put a bend in the wire at 24 feet, and then I measured the other 24 feet. And so right there is the very center part of the wire. The next step is to finally make up the matching cable. And actually I have an option here. I can do two different things. I have this nice SO239 chassis mount connector already on here, and I could use that, or I could take that off and I could pigtail the end of my RG11 and connect that directly to the antenna, which is what we normally do. But I'm kind of thinking differently here. I think I'll leave this on here. And then, see, if I pigtail the end of this and stretch that across there, I have a few extra inches left here of the cable, which is, you know, which I, you know, had, am going to need, because if I stretch this across, then my measurement is going to be from where those two pieces of cable, or two sections of cable, the shield and the center, are separated. And I'll start measuring from the inside of that split. Whereas with this, I think what I'll do is just go ahead and use a PL259 connector on each end of the RG11, and I will measure it from tip to tip instead of pigtailing it here and then trying to measure it out and that sort of thing. So. I'd move this out of the way and I get started on the matching cable. Now I'll get my PL259 connectors put on my matching cable. And looks like I am going to take off about, not quite an inch and a quarter, about an inch and 3/16 of an inch is how much of the jacket that I want to pull off. Like that. Slice across this without going through the braid. Should have marked it. A bunch of popping, then that means you're slicing through the shield. Okay. Now then, we want to take off about this much of the shield and the dielectric. Let's push this up a little bit. Yeah, about like that. You want to make sure that you get all of those little threads, all those pieces of the outer shield trimmed off so that nothing is touching the center. Okay, we'll slide this piece on and get the other piece on. Get that started. Kind of screws down into place there. Kind of push up and put it on. There's our center right there poking out. And here we can see the leads. So we've got that to solder. And we can take a multi-tester or the coaxial cable tester and check for continuity and make sure that that is not shorting out. So I'll take my 40 watt pencil iron here first and heat this up for a moment. You don't want too much solder or else it will flow back inside of it there. And now I'm going to take the big soldering iron, the 230/150 watt iron, and really heat up the outside of this connector and solder the shield. And I'll do this. go. Now I'm going to turn the cable. Fill in the other side. Once this thing gets hot, it's really hot. Might want to kind of smooth that out just a little bit right there. Just keep melting the solder and filling up the hole.